Nothing to see here. Well, another week passes and another batch of 2019 bikes to show you, and this week we're in Adelaide taking a gander at the latest from Focus. So let's get to it. Now, we'll start with the e-mountain bikes, shall we? Because in their own words, Focus are looking to own this space here in Australia, and they've got no less than 9 dual suspension e-mountain bike offerings coming to this country. We love the way that the Focus EMTBs all have a big on-off button right there on the middle of the top tube. It's like you're starting some kind of expensive German Mercedes or something like that. Across the whole range of Focus EMTBs, you'll find Shimano E8000 motors, as well as their fold suspension system, which is one that we're particularly fond of. So let's jump straight in and have a look at the Sam Squared. Now we've made no secret of the fact that we froth quite hard for long travel e-bikes, and Focus is certainly giving us what we like with the Sam Squared. It is a full-blown enduro bike with 170mm of travel at both ends, but with no hurt on the climbs. Unlike most e-bikes, the Sam Squared range doesn't use a plus size tyre. It opts instead for a conventional tyre, 2.4 inch front and rear, and that really speaks to the hard riding intentions of this bike. A lot of people who ride particularly hard do find that with a plus size tyre, the bike can feel a little bit squirmy and a bit fragile, and so you can really see the market that the Sam Squared is after just by the fact that they've spec'd tough, narrower tyres. Ah, that won't do. Back in Focus. Haha, get it? Now the battery on the Sam Squared isn't just integrated, it is fully housed right up inside the down tube, which means the whole thing is cleaner than a PG movie. It also means that the down tube can be made incredibly strong because it's not compromised by having to be open on any particular side. So you're getting a stiffer frame as well as a bike that looks fantastic. Plus you have the added bonus of being able to run a water bottle. Now, of course, the big trade-off here is battery capacity, and the battery you'll find on the Sam Squared and the Jam Squared is a 378 watt-hour battery, so a little bit less than some of the competition, most of which are around 500 watt-hours. But that said, one of the cool things with this bike is that you can add a second battery pack that just simply sits on top of the down tube where your water bottle would normally go, doubling your capacity. Of course, that will affect the weight and the handling of the bike, but if you do have a big epic ride coming up, at least you can put that second battery on there and know that you're not gonna run out of juice. Now, Focus like to let it be known that their e-mountain bikes handle just like a conventional mountain bike, or as close to it as they can possibly get, which is music to our ears, given that so many e-mountain bikes handle like a 1980s Volvo 240 GL. We're gonna be putting that claim to the test pretty soon. We have a Sam Squared and a Jam Squared coming our way for review, so keep an eye out for those. Now, if you don't want or don't need all of that 170mm of travel that you get with the Sam Squared, then you really should take a look at the Jam Squared range. There are amazingly 6 different models of the Jam Squared coming into Australia, all with 150mm of travel at both ends. There are wheel size options as well. You can get it in a 275 plus, a 29er, or a half and half model called the Drifter, which has a 29 inch wheel front and a 275 plus out the back. The carbon version of the Jam Squared is a real piece of work in a good way. Look how chunky and angular that head tube and top tube junction is. Seriously, you can land a small helicopter on top of that top tube. It is huge, and if you're going to be plowing into things fast with a e-bike, it certainly does wonders for your confidence to know that the frame is up to the job. The front end of this bike is all sharp angles and mean intentions. The use of carbon isn't just about saving weight and aesthetics though, it's all for stiffness, and this frame should be stiffer than your legs after a night sleeping in your car. Osher, he's got a book out, guys. So let's step away from the world of e-bikes for a tick and have a look at some of the conventional bikes in the range. And there is one bike in particular that really stands out to us, mainly because it is such exceptional value for money and delivers everything that we want in a trail bike. We're talking about the Jam 6.8, which comes in at a ridiculous $3,399. Now, I am an absolute sucker for a bright yellow bike, and I have really got my heart set on getting this one onto review ASAP. The 29er version of this bike is 140mm front and rear, and it is just a great looking all-round trail bike in our mind. Alloy frame, RockShox Revelation up front, SRAM NX Eagle drivetrain, Magura brakes, Maxxis tyres, KS dropper post. If we were looking for a do-it-all trail bike and didn't want to have to spend a bucket load of money, we think this one looks incredibly good on paper, and it's one of those bikes that's just sitting there, looks like it has the right geometry too, so it's going to be great to get this one onto review as soon as we can. For the XC race crowd, there is the Focus One series, spelled O1E. Now, all four models of this bike that are coming to Australia are in carbon. And as racetracks have started to get more and more technical, as we've seen from other brands, Focus have added a longer travel fork to their bike as well as dropper posts. So now you find 120mm travel fork on all models of the Focus One that are going to be coming to Australia. And two of those models also have a new KS abbreviated dropper post, which only has 50mm of travel but is perfect for a cross-country race bike, really. We think this is a super smart spec and definitely opens up the versatility of these bikes to people who aren't purely racing. There were two models of the Focus One on display here today, including the 9.9, which is the top shelf model, and the factory version, and both of them look so good we just wanted to throw on a set of Bibnix and get into it right here and now. The factory model in particular, with its RockShox RS1, its glowing fluoro yellow highlights, and its KS dropper post, is a very unique and glamorous looking cross-country race bike in particular. And the top shelf 9.9 model, which is dripping with the new 12-speed XTR, is a seriously lovely bike to behold. It has this red tinted lacquer over the raw carbon that just makes it look like some kind of deep piece of mahogany. It is a really gorgeous bike, though it will cost you 10 grand to call it your own. Okay, that'll do us for now. We're going to be doing our best to get some of these bikes on review ASAP, so make sure you keep your eyes here on Flow. And as always, if you like what we do, please subscribe and leave a comment below. We'd love to hear from you. Thanks very much. Cheers.